Hi. So the objective for this entire course is to develop a way of drawing whereby we can make a very simple sketch, have Grasshopper read parts of it, and give us back information about what we're drawing, and help us work out plans in a much more intelligent way. So this is a basic CAD drawing of a four-story building, which I'm using here as a reference to show you how layers should be set up to work to make drawing easy in Rhino, and then to pass that information on to Grasshopper. The first thing that we're going to do is create a set of layers. Now, these are going to help us organize the drawing and also split the information up to be analyzed in different ways. These aren't going to be traditional CAD layers. So, for example, we're going to have root layers according to the floor, so ground floor. And then ground floor is going to have 5 sublayers. First one is going to be a sketch layer, which isn't going to be red. It's just going to be a layer to keep all of the lines which you used to have as a temporary reference, but not be analyzed. Wall lines is going to be all the lines that denote walls or separations between zones. Division lines are going to be all the divisions between areas which aren't going to be separated by a wall, but you still want to separate them as independent areas to be analyzed. This is going to help us because in some of these cases we're going to want to draw walls, and on some of them we're just going to want to keep them as separate areas. We're going to want a layer for voids and a layer for text. And we'll see how all of these are useful throughout the course. Just give these their own color. All right, so now, since we have all the way up to third floor, we're just going to duplicate this, call it first floor, duplicate this, second floor. Okay. Now this is a way for us to show and hide what's on each of the layers and make sketching much easier. So now what we're going to do is just select each of the levels and put them into the sketch layer of each corresponding layer. So now it's quite easy to hide all of the content that we're going to be sketching on each layer. Now the next part is we're actually going to want to turn the seaplane of the view in order to be able to sketch according to the orthogonal axes of the plan that we want to draw. which in this case, you can see that it's not orientated with the y-axis. So the way that we do this is we go here, right-click top, set seaplane. Go to rotate. So all you have to do is first establish the z-axis, then take it from perfectly vertical to aligned with the drawing that we want to make. And that's it. So the reason we're doing this is to make sketching easy, and because besides having a set of sublayers for each of the floors or each of the plans, we're also going to want to have views aligned to each of these. So that's because, for example, if I wanted to sketch on first floor, that's here, and I begin to sketch here, that's still aligned to the seaplane for ground floor. So it's great to organize each of the plans according to its own seaplane. And the seaplanes are embedded in a view. So a view is not just a point of perspective
or a projection. It's also instructions about how to draw. So at the moment, the seaplane is orientated to ground floor, and that works for the ground floor level. So we're going to just save this view as ground floor view. So you do that by
going to named views, which is slightly out of the screen, but it's set view, named views. Okay, so I've deleted them, and now we're going to create a new one. So save as ground floor. And make sure that the top view is selected, because these are going to be for plans. So now every time you open this view, it's going to have its own ortho orientation, and it's going to have its seaplane set at the correct height. Now when you want to change the height of the seaplane in order to set views for the next levels, say we're going to show all of these, what you have to do is come here, make sure this is the one you're modifying, and go to set seaplane and elevation. And just touch a point on the level that you want, which is at this, in this case, 6 meters. And now you'll see that I've changed ground floor so that when I draw, make sure that project is on, because that's always going to draw on the seaplane for the view. You can see I'm drawing on the correct ortho axes. And when I check where it's drawn on the first floor. So that's basically it. That's how it works. So now you're going to want to click here and save this view as first floor. And just do the same thing again. Set seaplane, elevation, go to the second floor. And now just save this as second floor. Same thing for this one, for third floor. So that's perfect. Now, whenever I want to sketch on the third floor, I'll just click on the correct layers. I can hide everything else. I don't even have to look at the perspective view in order to check. I'm going to be sketching here, and I've got to make sure I'm on the third floor view. And as long as those two things are there, everything I sketch is going to be on the correct levels. So that's it. So now what we're going to do is just going to make a very simple sketch on ground floor. That's going to be the start of our analysis. And these are going to be wall lines. We're just going to create very, very basic areas so we can start putting them into a grasshopper analysis. So that's what we're going to start with. And just be confident that everything that you sketch with this system is going to be very well organized, and it's not going to create a mess further down the road when things get more complex and you have multiple levels and you need to be able to isolate things properly. And it's always going to maintain its 3D nature, which is important, because you want this to transfer into model very easily.